If you're ready to start using OBS Studio to start streaming to Twitch, in this video, I'm going to walk you step by step on how to go ahead and set up OBS, how to connect Twitch, and the best settings so you have the best looking stream possible. So the first thing you're going to do is to go to obsproject.com. This is how you're going to download OBS Studio, and any link that I mentioned, you're going to find in the description below. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to decide whether you're using a Windows or a Mac, and then you'll simply go ahead and download OBS. Once you have it downloaded, you're going to be brought to a screen just like this. Now, your initial going to be prompted with an auto config wizard, so we can kind of go through this because it's going to help us set up OBS as best as possible, at least to get started. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to optimize for streaming. Recording is secondary. We're going to hit next. You're then going to select your base canvas resolution. What I recommend that you utilize is whatever your monitor screen is, you can utilize that. But again, a 1920 by 1080 is always going to be a safe spot to be able to utilize. That's going to be the canvas, this black box you see around. It's what's going to be this canvas here. So I have it at 1920 by 1080 FPS. I like to go ahead and have it at 60 and then hit next. And now we want to connect Twitch to OBS. So what we want to do is we want to select Twitch, connect account recommended. So this is where you're now going to go ahead and get logged into your Twitch account. And then once you're logged in, you're going to see that you're going to have tons of new options available. So we'll hit login. It's going to ask me for an authenticator code here. Remember this. All right. And now once you get logged into your Twitch account, it says authenticating, it says prefer hardware encoding, estimate bitrate bandwidth. We can go ahead and say check to both of those, hit next. And now it's going to go ahead and begin to start testing to see what are going to be the best settings based on your computer that you're utilizing for Twitch. Now we're going to still go ahead and make some modifications to this ourselves, just because I know the best settings to be able to utilize to get 1080p 60 frames per second. Even if you're not an affiliate, even if you're not a partner, you're still going to be able to get a good quality. So what this is doing right now is looking for the best server on Twitch to be able to utilize. Again, the closer and the better the server you're utilizing on Twitch, the less lag you have, the less latency, the better experience your viewers are going to have. So once this is done, and again, it can take a few minutes, we're then going to go ahead and test our internet speed to be able to see where we're at. So right now, this is telling me that my video bitrate should be at 6,000. This should be what I should utilize for my settings. We'll simply select apply settings for now. And then you're going to see that you're going to get a few windows. Now, I don't utilize the stream information one. If you want to, you can put this here on the left, and then your stream chat, you can put it here to be able to go ahead and utilize. Now, for me, what I like to do is I like to go ahead and remove the stream information and just go ahead and leave the chat there. And now we have our canvas here. So the first thing we're going to want to do is we're going to want to go to speedtest.net. This is going to let us know what our internet speed is. And this is going to be super important. Whatever your upload speed is going to determine how smooth your stream is going to be. Are you going to lag? Can you support a high quality stream? So once you're here, you'll simply press go. And this is going to give you your download and your upload. What you want this upload number to be is at least 20. If you have at least 20 upload, you'll be good to be able to stream to Twitch at 1080p. 60 frames per second without any kind of issues. All right, so once you have that established, we're now going to go ahead and get the best settings to utilize in OBS so that way your stream looks smooth. So we're going to come here to where it says settings, and the first thing we're going to do is go to stream. We're going to make sure that everything is connected here, and we're going to make sure we have ignore streaming service setting recommendations. We then have to go to where it says video, where it says base canvas 1920 by 1080 output. We want this to be exactly the same. So we want that to be 1920 by 1080 and the common FPS values to be 60. Now we're going to come to output. This is where our settings are going to be the most important. By default, output mode is going to be simple. We want this to be advanced. So we'll select advanced. We'll come to streaming. Now, if you are on a Mac, these are going to be the settings you're going to utilize. And I'm going to show you the settings you will utilize if you're on a Windows. So if you're on a Mac, you're going to go to audio encoder, core audio AAC. Video encoder, Apple VT, hardware encoder, super important. Rate control, CBR, the bit rate. This is super important here. 7,750 is what you want to utilize. Now you may be like, hey, I've heard that only 6,000 is supported. If you utilize 7,750, you're going to be able to get a 1080p 60 frames per second live stream on Twitch. And if you want to come and check out my live stream at any point, I'm live Monday through Friday at 9 p.m. Eastern time on Twitch. And you can come check out the quality and ask questions to be able to help you out. Now the keyframe interval is going to be 2 seconds, profile high, and use B frames is going to be checked. Now, if you are on Windows, these are going to be the settings that you're going to want to utilize. You're going to have audio encoder FFmpeg AAC, NVIDIA NVIC H264, which is going to be your graphics card. Your rate control is going to be CBR. The bit rate, again, you want this to be at 7,750. And again, if you have at least a 15 upload, a 20 upload, you're going to be A-okay to be able to stream utilizing this. Your keyframe interval is going to be at 2. Your preset's going to be at P6, slower, better quality. Tuning is going to be at high quality. Multi-pass mode is going to be at 2 passes. Profile high. Look ahead on. Cycle visual tuning on. GPU 0. And max B frames 2. Once you have those settings there, we're going to go ahead and select OK. Now you're set up. So if we were to go press start streaming right now, your stream would go over to Twitch and you would be live. Now, what you want to do is you want to make sure your stream looks professional before you go live. And if you want to be able to go ahead and have overlays with a starting soon, a countdown timer, I want you to go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on setting up your overlays inside of OBS Studio to make your stream look professional. Click that video right there. I'll see you in the next video.